Hi, hello dear students of class 12. Very pleasant good morning to you all, and hope all of you are keeping fine and doing well in your studies as well as in your general life. Dear students, today we are going to complete the Tempest drama. Today we will be learning Act 5, Scene 1, text from 330 to 360, plus Epilogue 1 to 20. These are the texts that we are going to learn here. And as you are very much aware, this act consists of only one scene. One single scene, and we are in the last part of this drama today. In our previous class, you must have really understood that our King of Alonso, King of Naples Alonso, he was very much surprised to see his group members like Stefano, Tringolo and Caliban in a different form filled their bodies with scales of fish like, and he was very much astonished. That is the place where we have stopped. Let me take your attention to the present class, today's class. 325 onwards, I repeat. Stefano, oh touch me not, I am not Stefano, but a crab. Oh please don't touch me, I am not Stefano, I am a crab. That means I have total body ache, body pain. Prospero, you would be king of the isle, Sirrah? You want become the king of this island, Sirrah, fellow? You want become the king of this island? Stefano, I should have been a sore one then. In that case, I would have been a king full of pains then. If I have to be the king of this island, then definitely I will have full of pains in my life. Alonso, this is a strange thing as ever I looked on. This is the strangest thing that I have ever seen. Why? Because these three people, Caliban, Stefano and Tringolo, they are with scales on their body and they look entirely different. Pointing to Caliban, Prospero, he is as disproportioned in his manners as in his shape. Now Prospero is telling to Alonso, he is so disfigured as in his manner. As he looks disproportionate, his manner is also like that. Go, Sirrah, you fellow. Sirrah means you fellow. Go to my cell. Take with you your companions, that is Stefano and Tringolo. As you look to have my pardon, if you want to get my blessings and pardon, go to my cell and trim it handsomely. Trim it handsomely means clean, make it clean and neat and beautiful, my cell and surroundings. Who says? Prospero gave command to Caliban. Thus he is saying that if you want to get my favor, my forgiveness, do one thing. You go together with Stefano and Tringolo and trim my cell. Trim my cell means clean my house. Make the house clean and clean, neat and tidy, because King of Naples, Alonso, and his friends are going to sleep or spend the night there. Caliban, yes, I will do that one. And I will be wise hereafter and seek for grace. Yes, Hereafter, I will be very much careful. Hereafter, I will be very much careful to get your blessings or not to irritate to you. To get your grace means see, a goodwill for winning your goodwill. Hereafter, I will be very much grateful. Who? Caliban to Prospero. Yes. And he also feels that what a thrice double ass was I to take this drunkard for a god and worship this dull fool. You remember in our act 3 when our Caliban gave some drink to Stefano and Tringlo gave some drink to Caliban. He thought they are god, and he was even ready to lick the foot of Stefano and Tringlo, thinking that they were the gods. Now he realizes his folly, foolishness, and think that, see, what a thrice double ass was I. Oh, what a ass was I to take this drunkard, for god and worship this dull fool. Please listen the meaning. I will do so, and in future I will behave sensibly if I have to win your favor. What a donkey I was to take this drunkard for a god and worship this dull fool, referring to our Stefano and Tringulo. Prospero, go to away. Well then, go and do as I ordered you. Yes, immediately go and get away from here and do as I told you. Alonso, hence, and bestow your luggage where you found it. Bestow, dispose. Bestow means dispose your luggage. Here, luggage is referring to the stolen apparel of Prospero. Yes. Place the luggage from where you have taken it. Keep it there. Hence, and bestow your luggage where you found it. Sebastian, or stole it rather. Found it, it is not found, but it was stolen. Yes. Place the things there. Exeunt Caliban, Stefano, and Tringulo. Prospero, sir, I invite your highness and your train to my poor cell. I invite you and your train. Your train means attendants, not the train of our Krishak Express or Rajdhani Express, Chauri Chaura Express. No. Train, you remember already, you are familiar with this term in our Merchant of Venice in class 9, and of course in 10 also you have learned that Prince of Morocco came with his train attendants. That is the meaning. Thus our Prospero is inviting King of Naples Alonso and his train attendants to take rest in the cell. Where you shall take your rest for this one night. Where you will take rest for this one night. Which part of it, of this one night, I will waste with such discourse as I no doubt shall make it. Go quick away. Yes, here, after reaching there, much of the time I am going to tell you about my life story and all that I have experienced here in this island. I will waste with such discourse. Discourse means talk. Thus, Prospero is inviting King Alonso and his attendants to his cell and ask the king to take rest, and he also promises to tell the story of his life and all that he had experienced after reaching this particular island. No doubt shall make it. Go quickly away. Go quickly away means, here means quick away. The night will be passed very soon by hearing this story. The story of my life and the particular accidents gone by since I came to this isle. Yes, I'm going to narrate to you the story of my life and all the things that I have experienced after coming in this particular island. And in the morning, and in the morning I will bring you to your ship. I will take you to your ship and so to Naples. And from there you will be going to into Naples, where I have hope to see the nuptial. Nuptial means the marriage. Nuptial blessing means the marriage blessing. Where I hope to see the nuptial of this our dear beloved solemnized. There I would like to see the marriage blessing of our Ferdinand and Miranda. And then retire me to my Milan. After seeing the marriage in Naples, I will go back to Milan, where every third thought shall be my grave, whereupon I will be spending my future thinking about my grave, means my death. Dear students, please pay attention to the meaning of this long dialogue of our Prospero, starting from 340 to 350. Please pay attention. Prospero. Now, sir, I invite your honor and your attendance to my humble cell, where you may rest tonight. I will spend a part of this night telling you about things which will make your time pass quickly. It will be the story of my life and all that I had suffered, as well as all that happened since I arrived on this particular island. Then in the morning, I will take you to your ship, which will take us to Naples, where I hope to see the solemn marriage of our dearly loved ones, referring to Ferdinand and Miranda. After that, I will retire to my estate in Milan. That is dukedom, where much of my future shall be spent in meditation on death. After reaching Milan, I will spend much of my time thinking about my death, about my grave. Hope the test is clear for you. Alonso, I long to hear the story of your life. Yes, I seriously desire to listen the story of your life, which must take the years strangely. I long to hear the story of your life, which must captivate the attention of everybody. Thus, when Prospero told that I'm going to narrate the story of my life and all the things that I experienced here in this island, Alonso told, yes, I would like to hear that particular story that would captivate the attention of everybody. Hope the test is clear for you. 355, test number 355. Prospero, I will deliver all. Deliver means I will narrate all. I will tell everything. Deliver means to deliver the speech. Speak, that is called deliver. And promise you calm seas. And I promise you calm seas. Calm seas means pleasant sea without any turbulence. Yes. Auspicious gales. Gales means winds, pleasant wind. And sail so expeditious that shall catch your royal fleet far off. Yes. I will tell you everything. And I promise you calm seas without any turbulence. And of course, auspicious, pleasant wind. And sail so expeditious. Expeditious means efficiently. The sail which will go very efficiently, that shall catch your royal fleet far off. The royal ship, the ship that has already gone ahead of our Alonso's ship. Aside to Ariel, my Ariel chick, my bird, lovingly, very fondly, Prospero calls Ariel as my little chick, my little bird. That is thy charge, that is your responsibility. Then to the elements be free, then go. You are free, and fare thou well, and goodbye to you. Please you draw near. Please, you know, please, sir, come this way. So this is what our Prospero is telling. Please understand the explanation of 355. Prospero, I will tell you everything. Now I promise you calm seas, favorable winds, and a voyage so speedy that you will catch up with your royal fleet, which has already covered a long distance. Aside to Ariel, my Ariel, my dear bird, you have to make all the arrangements for this journey. After that, you will be free to roam about in the air, and I bid you goodbye. Please, sir, come this way. So finally, our Prospero is taking or leading Alonso to his cell in a particular way. Exhumed. So they all exhumed. Now, epilogue spoken by Prospero. Dear friends, in the Shakespearean plays or the plays of earlier centuries, famous writers, they used to end the drama or the play with an epilogue. By the way, what is an epilogue? It's a short speech spoken directly to the audience at the end of the play. Thus our Prospero comes before the audience and give a concluding speech, winding up speech directly to the audience, which will indicate the play is samapt, khatam ho gaya hai. Okay, let me explain the epilogue also, then we will be also completing the total drama. Epilogue spoken by Prospero. Now my charms are all overthrown. Now Prospero has given up all the magical powers of his life, overthrown, and what strength I have is my own, which is most faint. What I have is my feeble strength. Very, see, human beings, they are very helpless. The weakest creatures in the world, human beings, though at times we feel that we are very much powerful, strong, having the power like Hercules. No, dear students, we are very much helpless and powerful. Thus, once the magical power of Prospero is given up, he has just become a feeble person, very weak person, very ordinary human being. Yes, and what strength I have is my own, which is most faint. Faint means very feeble. Now it's true, I must be here confined by you. Now it is true that I should be confined here by you or spent to Naples. It is up to you to confine me to here or take me to Naples. Let me not, since I have my dukedom got. So let me not stay here, since I have got back my dukedom in Milan. God and pardon the deceiver. I have forgiven all my enemies, all my foes. Dwell in this bare island by your spell. No, I do not want to. As I have forgiven all my enemies, and as I have got my dukedom back, I don't want to stay here. So let me also go by. But release me from my bands. My bands here means, see, from release me from my magic power. Bands, with the help of your good hands. Gentle breath of yours, my sails must fill, and or else my project fails, which was to please. Now I want spirits to enforce, art to enchant, and my ending is despair, unless I be relieved by prayer, which pierces so that it assaults mercy itself and frees all faults. As you from crimes would pardon be, let your indulgence set me free. Indulgence means kindness. Let your indulgence set me free. Thus our our Prospero is making the final epilogue to our King Alonso to release him from this particular island and take him to Milan, be the Duke there. Let me give the meaning of this epilogue and let us wind up the class. Now I do not have my magical powers and have only my own feeble strength. Here I must be detained by you. Here you can keep me here or send back to Milan to look after it as the Duke. Here you can detain, keep me back here in this island, or you can take me back to Milan to be the Duke of Milan. All my foes who wronged me are hereby forgiven. I forgive all my enemies who have done wrong things against me. It would be set to keep me here on this barren island. It would be set to keep me here on this island. I request you to release me from this confinement with a good applause. I request you to release me from this particular island with a good applause. That helped me in the past. Let the favorable winds drive our sails, or else my plan, which was to please you, is doomed to fail. Now I lack the attending spirits as well as my magical skills. Now I don't have any more spirits to assist me, or I do not have any magical power in me to perform anything. I will be in despair. Unless your prayers bring me forgiveness and mercy from heaven above, which liberates man from his faults. We all are liberated from our mistakes by the divine mercy of God. As you would like to be forgiven of your sins, you forgive your sins, you forgive your enemies, then your sins are also forgiven. The beautiful Our Father prayer you have heard, isn't it? We pray, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Do not bring us to a test, but deliver us from evil. Amen. That is the prayer. So if you forgive, definitely your sins also will be forgiven by God. So, to get the blessings of God, this part already you have learned in Merchant of Venice, Portia's speech on mercy, isn't it? Yes. Mercy, it is like double blessing. The giver is blessed, the receiver is also blessed in the same way. If you want your sins to be forgiven by God, then you should be ready and willing to forgive the sins of your fellow brethren, fellow sisters and brothers. Yes. So, as you would like to be forgiven of your sins, free me from here with your prayers. So, please free me from this island and take me to Milan to be the Duke of there. Yes, dear students, hope the things are clear for you. The epilogue is clear for you. What is the content of epilogue? Once again, let me summarize. Our Prospero is making a request to our Alonso, the King of Naples, to take him back to Milan to be the Duke of Milan. Thus, we wind up the class here. Thus, we have completed the total syllabus for your examination. Now you are ready for your English literature paper. Yes, dear students, hope the class is clear for you. In case of any clarifications or doubt, please don't hesitate to contact me. I will keep in touch with you and I will help you in the best possible way. All right. So for your work now, I set the ball in your court. Please work hard, learn it, and get the best result out of your exam. All right, that is my humble prayer. All right, so we have concluded, and I would like to thank you. Yes. Thank you very much. Completed. All right. So, please read the test 2-3 times, listen the video, and make notes and do all the preparations for your examination. All the best. So, once again, I'm just signing out from this class to meet you in our next class, which we will be learning about our English grammar. All right, until then, goodbye. Have a nice day. God bless you. Thank you.